Καλησπέρα. Gracias, compañeros, por permitirme traerles este abrazo entrañable desde la América Latina. Thanks a lot for allowing me to share with you some reflections about the struggles against neoliberalism in Latin America, precisely because they are trying to do exactly the same to you. And they are not only trying to destroy the European civilization, they are trying to destroy a balance of power, a global balance of power against the peoples in the world. So we have to defend Europe. We have to defend what you have constructed here. The future of humanity is at stake here. The violence of the colonial incorporation of Latin America to the West European world system 5 centuries ago broke the organic coherence between production and consumption previously achieved under very different modes of production and of life under a mosaic of very different indigenous cultures. Not even independence had allowed us to re-achieve this situation. The significant construction of domestic macroeconomic sovereignty in response to the crisis of the 30s and the auspicious framework of Bretton Woods Accords of 1944 was systematically eroded by the deinstitutionalization and the fiscal austerity policies triggered by those cycles of external restriction linked to the commercial and technological dependence. The social resistance required higher and more sophisticated doses of repression. Finally, what even the bloody military dictatorships of the South Congo with thousands of victims were unable to do was achieved generally under representative democracy with the effects of the external debt crisis engineered by them in the 80s. The Anglo-American need for further realms of speculation after the unilateral rupture of the dollar gold standard in 1971 has been frustrated everywhere for almost a decade of resilience of fixed exchange regimes and firm regulation until the Federal Reserve Chairman Paul Volcker's decision of increasing the interest rates from 3 to 18%, suddenly rendering unbearable the growing public and private debt in dollars in the South and in the East. The colossal blackmailing power that the debt crisis gave to the IMF and the World Bank paradoxically destroyed the Bretton Woods Accords schemes, launching a 30-year-long race to the bottom of hundreds of countries desperately trying to create surpluses in dollars to service the debt, disputing shares of the markets through incessant devaluations, privatizations, deindustrialization, and financial and monetary deregulation. A decade of social shocks in every country created political havoc and democratic degradation in such a level that the imperialist agenda could push further with the Washington Consensus and the structural reforms that installed internal dynamics of destruction of every dimension of sovereignty and solidarity. The stick and the carrot of differentiated and postmodern consumerism versus unemployment and pauperization place every category of workers and every nation against each other, easing the extraction of absolute surplus value and accumulation by disposition, with accelerated processes of transnational monopolization and the endless begging for more debt to pay the debt reinforces the systematic expropriation of policy space of nations and individuals. The constitution of the WTO and the multiplication of investment protection agreements during the 90s demanded deeper concessions of sovereignty and destroyed productive fabric with the contrasting reward of the new enclaves of denationalized growth. The example of the North American Free Trade Agreement and the social crisis that has provoked in Mexico shows those instruments' powers of disintegration. The blitzkrieg of the American and European monopolies over the continent was going to culminate with ALCA, the Free Trade Agreement for the Americas, but the awakening of the peoples broke the trend. In the middle of the generalized cornering of progressive forces and the dissolution of the traditional social movements based on class demands, new political processes started to emerge everywhere in Latin America. Beyond the continuous large political constructions of the PT in Brazil and the PRD in Mexico is the eruption of emerging extra-institutional anti-neoliberal alternatives that transform the force correlations in the continent. With mutinies in Venezuela, popular revolts in Bolivia, the indigenous and urban rebellion in Ecuador, the general strikes in Argentina, etc. Chavez's first out of 14 electoral victories in 1998 starts a sequence of very precarious institutional disputes accepting, questioning the economic and legal rules of the game. The combination of all forms of struggles with diversity and even organic polarization, but with solid convergence against the neoliberal policies, allowed a weak but constant reversion of the neoliberal destruction of the Latin American societies. The heterogeneous progressive governments, fruit of these processes, had given a qualitative support to the permanent dispute, but still in the terrain of the neoliberal regimes of accumulation. And with the reality of a degradation of the historical subject of the transformation and the societal projects. Dialectic contradictions plagued the slow recovery of national sovereignty, now organically linked to the continental integration. Initiatives like UNASUR, CELAC, ALBA, etc., with a generalized concern for poverty reduction and the decisive role of public investment. The differentiated advances in each national process require now a consolidation of possibilities with a new regional financial architecture, both at the domestic level with debt auditing and restructuring, with regulation, with construction of sovereign systems of credits and payments, and at the regional level with Bank of the South, Fund of the South, and the common, not unique currency, the Sucre, the unitarian system of international settlements. A common position facing the multinational corporations and the free trade agreement after the defeat of the ALCA in 2005. Comrades, another world is possible, but only upon the basis of further and further building of national and grassroots capabilities. Viva el Foro Social Europeo, viva la cumbre alternativa aquí en Atenas. ¡Viva la lucha! Gracias.